2014 now, and our exclusive Eyewitness News Providence Journal poll. Throughout our newscast, we'll be releasing poll results on the major races going into the September primary. New at 5, we examine the Rhode Island Lieutenant Governor's race. Let's get to Target 12 investigator Tim White, who has the exclusive numbers in campaign 2014.
There are 3 Democrats running in the primary for Lieutenant Governor, and our results show there is still a lot that can happen in the next 3 weeks. We asked 500 likely Democratic primary voters who they would choose for Lieutenant Governor if the election were held today. 25% say the current Secretary of State, Ralph Mollis. Cumberland Mayor Dan McKee gets 15%, followed by State Representative Frank Ferry with 10%. But the big number is who aren't sure yet. 47% haven't made up their mind. Eyewitness News political analyst and pollster Joe Fleming says this race has been in the shadows during a busy political season.
Again, this race has not got a lot of play. The voters probably are not tuned in on it at all. And as a result, you know, with almost half the vote is undecided, you don't know what's going to happen on primary day in this race.
Breaking down the numbers, the results show Mollis is winning with registered Democrats and union households. But again, a lot of voters are undecided. The primary is September 9th. Now, coming up new at 5:30, results in the race for Secretary of State. And at 6, a major headline from this poll in the race for General Treasurer. With the Target 12 investigators, I'm Tim White, Eyewitness News.
To campaign 2014 now, and our exclusive Eyewitness News Providence Journal poll. With just 3 weeks until the primary, we're taking a close look at the major races and bringing you the results from our poll throughout our newscast. Now, new at 5:30, the race for Secretary of State. Let's get to Target 12 investigator Tim White, who has the exclusive numbers in campaign 2014.
This is the first public poll with results on this race. We asked 500 likely Democratic primary voters who they would choose for Secretary of State if the election were held today. We found that 27% of those polled say they would vote for Guillaume de Ramel, 13% for Nelly Gorbea, but a whopping 57% of those we polled aren't sure who they would vote for. Eyewitness News political analyst and pollster Joe Fleming says with just 3 weeks left, each candidate will have to dive into their campaign accounts to get noticed.
You have to spend and spend to try to get yourself known, because like as you said, Tim, the governor's race is sucking all the oxygen out. And as a result, it's hard for these other races to show any traction at all, unless something big happens that turns the race around.
Whoever wins in the September 9th primary will face Republican John Carlevalli in the November election. Now, coming up at 6, big news in the Democratic race for general treasurer between Frank Caprio and Seth Magaziner. With the Target 12 investigators, Tim White, Eyewitness News.
Now we turn to campaign 2014 and our exclusive Eyewitness News Providence Journal poll. Next to the race for governor, the Democratic primary battle for general treasurer has gotten the most attention. Now, in our last poll, former treasurer Frank Caprio was ahead of newcomer Seth Magaziner. But a lot has happened in the last 3 months, having a dramatic effect on the numbers. Let's get to Target 12 investigator Tim White with the exclusive results.
For starters, the race for treasurer went from 3 Democrats to 2. Now Frank Caprio's lead has evaporated, and Seth Magaziner has built a double-digit advantage.
Now, I was supportive of the...
After trailing in the polls in the race for general treasurer, Democrat Seth Magaziner has ripped open a lead over his rival, former treasurer Frank Caprio. We asked 500 likely Democratic primary voters who they would choose for treasurer if the election were held today. 43% say Magaziner, while 31% say Caprio, 24% aren't sure.
Magaziner has shown a lot of growth, and the question is, we don't know if the growth is a favorable Magaziner vote or an anti-Caprio vote.
Eyewitness News political analyst and pollster Joe Fleming says many factors play into Magaziner's surge, but recent news over a state police investigation into a beach concession contract involving Caprio's brother may be weighing on his campaign.
That's played out in all the media. It's played out in the print media, and I think that's become a focal point at this point. And I think I have to believe that has hurt Frank Caprio in this race.
On top of that, Fleming says Magaziner has recently spent a lot of money on TV ads, and he benefited when candidate Ernie Almonte dropped out of the Democratic primary to run as an independent. Fleming says it appears those who were voting for Almonte have shifted to Seth Magaziner. The primary is September 9th. With the Target 12 investigators, Tim White, Eyewitness News.
And tomorrow on Eyewitness News This Morning, we'll bring you the results everyone is waiting for. Who's winning in the hotly contested Democratic primary for governor? We'll have those poll numbers starting at 5 a.m. tomorrow right here on Eyewitness News.